An aphorism about the universe. The universe is a contingent hologram in a zero-dimensional point given to appear as four dimensions in the infinite dimensions of the mind of God. I found the report remarkable that just 25 firms produce the majority of greenhouse gases of the Earth the past 30 years. Governments that produce oil and gas are the worst offenders, yet one can't disregard the contributions of ExxonMobil, Shell, BP, Chevron, Peabody, and BHP Billiton, according to the report. Top state-owned emitters included Saudi Arabia, Aramco, Gazprom, and National Iranian Oil. This was at Inside Climate News /10727 Fossil Fuel Companies Responsible Global Emissions CDP report. The Chinese government's coal mining is a vast left-wing pollution source. The bright spot in the report of 636 gigatons of global warm gas released by the top 100 offenders since 1988 is that if they were to stop or to evolve to non-polluting status, the world would be much better off. Yet they have so much economic power and ad hoc neo-funky supporters politically, it's improbable. Alaska legislature votes to stop subsidizing oil development with cash. It is only because the state needs the cash themselves and can't afford to give hundreds of millions away each year anymore that the policy ended. It's not like they were hit on the head by an apple and discovered that oil is not the only way for the state government to fund itself. The cash payment should have been to startups in fuel cell power plants and wind farms, geothermal power generation, and so forth, instead of oil. Legislators know only the simplest, most solid revenue sources to support, and don't look any farther, so the state is always lagging behind progress. It is an example of what several historians have pointed out about ossification that sets in on a society's economic infrastructure that makes it improbable to change and adapt, hastening their downfall in regard to other societies. With Alaska being just a state instead of a nation, process is dampened by federal redistributionism. Yet it is fun to watch the lemmings repeat the same historical trails in real time anyway. There was an article at the Alaska Dispatch that venture capital is key to modern Alaska economy that was well worth reading, to how to develop alternative economic modes. For economic reasons, people form arguments against rational scientific analysis of environmental degradation caused by human economic methods, supported by government running decades behind any sort of leading edge on progress. Coursera.org offers free, high-quality college courses online. Democracy does have a responsibility to conserve the well-being of the interests of the people to a certain extent, read a philosophy of government textbook, rather than abandon it and just go along with plutocratic globalism. Democratic governments need not necessarily be stupid for philosophical reasons to avoid communism or led by smart communists in government. Yes, oxymorons. Some comprehend why economic diversity and conservation of state resources are desirable, however, rather than to allow the powerful to skim everything with sycophant legislators. Government can encourage development of business startups with incentives and not run business. Public schools and unionism that attack small individual free enterprise building trades are more exemplary of neo-communist or mob-like structures. The United States already produces about as much oil as Saudi Arabia and probably will continue to do so for the next 20 years. Legislature should not pay a dime to oil producers. The entire industry is, of course, about money rather than good government, good environmentalism, or concern for the people. I enjoyed working for a while offshore in oil exploration long ago and learned something about the paradigm. It has good technology, yet it is a mistake for Alaska to contribute a dime. Oil takes care of itself. Free enterprise, corporatism, tremendous wealth, global politics, and all that. They're not reluctant to cost you dearly. The state should support diversification in energy economics and efficiency in government. Adam Smith said to let the free hand of enterprise guide economics and did not say that the private sector should replace government. Environmental conservation is vital. Life is to continue on Earth as 9 to 12 billion people plunder it later this century. A premium needs to be put on intelligence in government. The oil patch for Alaska is part of the world reserve, and that is global. Prudhoe Bay, probably be another Prudhoe Bay with fracking, as could Soda Fields be entirely renewed. There is more oil than the world needs or ought to use. Water quality needs to be a concern for frackers. Meanwhile, fuel cell and battery-powered vehicles are surging ahead, and the demand should decrease for waste, gas, and fossil fuel cars. I suppose that state expenses and buildings and highways could be more efficiently used, and the costs of schools could decrease, while income tax could actually be made to exist with a rebate to state residents in the form of a residence dividend equal to the basic income tax. The Alaska Permanent Fund was made to increase through excellent investing, yet the state does not invest in attracting practical revenue-generating technology terribly well, perhaps fuel cell power plants. Fundamentally, the state services unions and old-style economics, lacking creativity with loyalty to oil. The likely meltdown of a quarter of Alaska's permafrost by the year 2100 isn't good for several reasons, the least of which is not that it will allow more methane to be released into the atmosphere. Methane is an extreme greenhouse gas. As Arctic permafrost melts, methane gas rises to the top through new fast tracks to trade through the dark of deep Antarctic gloom for the airy blue sky. It's bad enough that just 25 state and corporate producers release the majority of human-sourced greenhouse gases, and with permafrost melting, allowing more biogenic methane and apparently geologically sourced methane to trickle up to the atmosphere from its deep containment, the prospects for an age more suitable for dinosaurs looks good. Lucky that genetic engineering may allow restoration of dinosaurs before humanity dies from heat exhaustion. There was an article at Inside Climate News, 1807/Arctic permafrost melting methane emissions geologic sources